So in this video, I'll do an example of one prop Z test. And this is used when we're doing a hypothesis test with one proportion. We have an example. According to the Census Bureau, 15.6% of the US population had no health insurance coverage in 2003. A random sample is taken, 1,200 Americans, and 216 had no health insurance. We're going to use a 0.02 significance level to test the claim that the current percentage of Americans who have no health insurance coverage is equal to 15.6%. So to do this on the calculator, we want to go to stat and then over to tests. So you can scroll over to tests. And then we want to find one prop Z test. For me, that's number 5. So I'm going to choose it and I'll press enter. And then the information that one prop Z test wants is it wants P naught, and that just means your proportion for the null hypothesis. So what do you believe, you know, what is the past idea that is believed to be true? And that's 15.6% having no health insurance. So we'll write that as a decimal, 0.156. Then the X and the N are the new information, this new sample that's taken, where X is the number of successes. So those, in this case, are people that had no health insurance, of which there were 216. The N is the total number of people that were surveyed, that is 1,200. And then the prop just means, what is the alternative hypothesis here? And are we talking about not equal to, less than, or greater than that null hypothesis? So in this case, we're just testing the claim that the current percentage of Americans who have no health insurance is equal to 15.6%. So when we're given something like that, that tells us that that is the claim, you know, is the null hypothesis. So therefore, the alternative is going to be a not equal to. We're not seeing any words that are giving us any idea that we would be using a different inequality there. So the opposite of equal to 15.6 is going to be not equal to 15.6. And so I choose not equal to P naught, and then I scroll down to calculate. So the information that comes out of one prop Z test, the first line is simply your alternative hypothesis, that the proportion that came from the recent random sample is not equal to the 0.156 from the past. The next value is your test statistic, your Z test statistic. The value after that is your p-value. Your p-value is the probability of getting data from that random sample like you did, or data more extreme if the null hypothesis is true. So that's your p-value. The next value is your p-hat. That is simply the 216 divided by 1,200. So it's doing that proportion for you and getting that proportion and giving you what it is as a decimal. And the last value is your N, which you already know, which is the value in your random sample. So you can take that information, and that will help you draw the conclusion in a hypothesis test for a proportion.